Okay, so let's continue. And our next speaker is Vladimir Stukupin, with a talk on Hopf superalgebra structures, on quantum superalgebras and quantum veil groupoid. Please.
Thank you for presentation. And first of all, I thanks to organizers to opportunity give a talk at this nice conference. And my talk sorry, my some technical problem. And my talk will be devoted to the relation between Jungian of quantum Jungian of Lie superalgebras and quantum loop superalgebra. Excuse me, can you see my
my yes, we see, but not full screen, but okay.
Ah, yes, I have some technical problem.
Просмотр, да.
Oh, okay, that's and the initial point of our study is by Boltam and Toledana Lareda. In this paper, these authors establish existence of isomorphism between completions of the Jungian of simple Lie algebra and quantum loop algebra. And in this paper, this author didn't consider the relation between Hopf superalgebra structures on this quantum superalgebras between by Grünfeld definition of quantum algebras. The quantum algebras appear as a quantization of the sum structure of the algebra. And in the case of quantum algebras, we have theorem on existence and uniqueness of such quantization. And in the case of Jungian of simple Lie algebras and quantum loop algebras, the existence of isomorphism, of algebraic isomorphism, has as a corollary isomorphism between Hopf superalgebra structure. But in the case of Lie superalgebra, we have many different Hopf superalgebra structures on the quantum superalgebra. For example, if we consider the special linear superalgebra, in this case, we obtain various Cartan matrices and various root system in this case. And but we obtain the isomorphic superalgebras, but these isomorphic superalgebras defined by various Cartan dates. And as a corollary of this fact, we obtain that in the case of the superalgebra, we have many different non-adjoint Borel sub superalgebras and have various triangular decomposition. By the infield quantization can be defined as deformation of the algebra structure or equivalent or equivalently as deformations of structures which defined by Manning triples. And if we have different cases of such general decomposition, we obtain the various Hopf superalgebra structure on the corresponding quantum superalgebra. And the same case we have in the case of Jungian and quantum Hopf superalgebra. And natural question, how to describe such Hopf superalgebra structure in this case? Follow Toledano Lareda and Gautam, we can consider the same isomorphism between completion of Jungian and completion of quantum Hopf superalgebra, and we obtain some isomorphic structure of associative.
Are you changing your slides?
Okay, yes.
Because we see just the first one.
Thank you. Your remark, but I try to give some introduction to the question. And the question is how to describe such Hopf superalgebra structure on this object. In the case of superalgebra, we have some analog of Weyl group, so-called Weyl groupoid. The Weyl groupoid is a very natural extension of Weyl group. Weyl group, I recall, the group which generated by the reflection relatively simple roots. In the case of superalgebra, only in the case when we have reflection relatively even root, we obtain the action in the fixed only reflection relatively simple roots preserve the system of the simple root. But if we consider reflection relatively odd root, this reflection change the system of simple root, but preserve system of all roots. And therefore, the action of Weyl groupoid can change the Borel superalgebras in the case of Lie superalgebra. And as a corollary of this fact, we can obtain that if we consider the quantum, the action of quantum Weyl groupoid, we can obtain the action of the family of quantum superalgebras, which parameterized by Cartan datum, by Cartan data. And in this case, naturally, consider many quantum superalgebras, which has various Hopf superalgebra structure. And action of quantum groupoid can change this Hopf superalgebra structure. And in the terms of quantum Weyl groupoid, we going to describe the relation between between different Hopf superalgebra structure on the fixed quantum superalgebra, which we consider as a quantum algebra. That's quantum associative algebra. I recall that by the infield, the quantum algebra is a deformation of structure of so-called Lie algebra. I recall that the Lie algebra is a tension space to the Poisson group. Lie algebra is Lie algebra G such that the dual vector space G star is also Lie algebra. And bracket on G induced by the operation of the bracket on G star is one possible these coefficients in the model G times G. And model structure is defined by action A on the tensor square of Lie superalgebra is defined by the following formula. And this general approach to the quantization follows violated. And the main object is my report, the enough important classes of the quantum algebra, Sandian and quantum loop algebra. Was this object, each quantization of the followed by algebras, correspondingly Yang-Gyan current Lie algebra, algebra of polynomial currents, is various in the superalgebra G, and loop Lie algebra, superalgebra of loops, Laurent polynomial mappings with values in the same superalgebra G. And, this object has bracket and co-brackets, which can be defined using some standard R matrices. Or by equivalent way using the language of Manning-Tripp. And quantization of such structures is a family of associative hoop superalgebras, which depends from parameter h bar and which satisfies some axiom. And the main axiom of this the fact if we consider difference between co-multiplication and opposite co-multiplication, model h bar each coincide is action of co-bracket delta, which co-bracket acts in the corresponding Lie B superalgebra. And the main object of our study, initial Lie superalgebra, Lie special linear superalgebra. And I'm going to consider the following problem. First of them, isomorphism between completion of the quantum loop of superalgebra, where G is special linear superalgebra, and completion of the Yang-Gyan of this superalgebra, the analog of the result of Gautam and Kalidan-Larreta. The second problem, equivalence between some counterparts of category O of representations of super Jungian and quantum loop superalgebra. Second problem, description of superalgebra of Hopf superalgebra structures for super Jungians and quantum loop superalgebra and relation between the structures. This problem was related to the construction of quantum affine variable point. And the description of the structures can be done in the terms of the action of part of the variable point. And the fourth problem, which in progress, geometric representation theory, study of Nakajima supervarieties, which related to above mentioned object. First of all, I try to explain the isomorphism between Jungian and quantum loop superalgebra. In the quasi-classical limit, as above mentioned, Jungian coincides with current Lie algebra, and quantum loop algebra in the limit coincides with loop superalgebra. And in this case, we can consider natural homomorphism which is defined on generators by the full formula, some analog exponential mappings. We can define this homomorphism on generators by the full formula. We can correspond to the monomial current x times t up n, t degree n, the x tensor exponent ms. Right side of this model has the decomposition in the infinite series. And in this slide, this mapping acting not a current algebra, exactly in completion. In completion, in this case, the algebra of formal power series. And you obtain some homomorphism from algebra into completion of current superalgebra, namely in the superalgebra of formal power series. And how to describe this the quantum analog of this method? On this slide, I recall the definition of superalgebra, special linear superalgebra, which superalgebra defined by can be defined in the terms of Cartan Weyl generators, and is defined by the same way as a simple Lie algebra. We have the same relation which Cartan generators, Cartan Weyl generators, and we have also shared generators and some complementary shared generators, which show on this slide. And about quantum loop superalgebra. Quantum loop superalgebra can be defined as factor superalgebra of quantum affine superalgebra. And if we have the same relation, we must include it only relation with central element C and gradient element D. We have some relation between Cartan generators, capital H, between Borel positive element of generators of positive Borel superalgebra, negative F Borel superalgebras, and the sum analogs of this relation U6 and U7 complementary shear relation, which relatively generators E, capital E, capital A. And also can introduce the sum generators psi IR and phi IR, which can be expressed in the term of these generators, so-called algorithmic generators of the Cartan superalgebra, and which contains the following formula. Each generators will appear in the formula for isomorphism. And the same way we can introduce the Young-Young as associative superalgebra generators by generators X, I, R, and H. I, R, H, I, R is the generators of the Cartan algebras, sub-superalgebra, and X plus minus I, R, these are generators of which belongs to the positive and correspondingly negative Borel sub-superalgebras. And we have the some counterpart of the relation for the rule superalgebra. But in difference of previous case, the second indices goes to the natural positive integer numbers. In the case of the loop superalgebras, second index belongs to the set of all integers. And we have the same relation y1, y2, and so on, y7, which are counterparts of the corresponding relation for quantum loop superalgebra. And if we fixed distinguished Cartan diagram in this case, only generators with first index m plus one is odd. But in the case of the arbitrary Dynkin diagram, we have some distinguished subset of set of simple root, which can be odd. Which can be odd roots. In the simple case of the superalgebra SL2-1, we have the system which consider two roots. In this case, we have two different Dynkin diagram, two different system simple root. One of them has one even and one simple roots, and the second case, both roots are odd. You can restrict yourself considering this simple case to understand the general picture. The construction of isomorphism is based on the representation theory, and I explain how maybe later I explain the structure of the simple models in the case of Young-Young and quantum loop superalgebra. First of all, I try to introduce construction of isomorphism between quantum loop superalgebra, between completion quantum loop superalgebra and Young-Young. I define this isomorphism on generators by the following formula. These formulas are analogs of the corresponding formula by Toledana, Lareda, and Gautam. And for Cartan generators, this formula is an analog classical case. T with indices I and K, these analogs of the generators of algorithmic generators of Yang Yang. And this generators is defined by the this formula in terms of generative system. The formal power series generating power series for generators TIR is equal logarithm from generating series for generators HIR. And the action phi on the Borel generators is defined by the complex formulas and in terms of generators E and F and coefficients of this decomposition is defined in terms of such generating function, which is defined by expression which contains the sum analog of Cauchy kernel integral transformation. And in the formula present also some shift operator C sigma plus minus is indices I, which shifted the second numbers of the Borel generators. And the main theorem asserts that the mapping which define above mentioned formulas is monomorphism in the quantum loop superalgebras to the completion Yang-Yang, and this isomorphism can be uniquely continued to the isomorphism between completions of these superalgebras. Completion of this as the isomorphism of these completions. The main idea of proof of this theorem to reduce to them.
Володя, 5 minutes remains.
Oh, okay, thank you. The main idea to reduce to the case of super algebras SL11 and SL2. The case SL2 was considered by Teledon already, and we consider only a case SL11. The main tools in the proof of this theorem is the using of Borel transformation, which extends on the algebraic case, and using construction of the universal Yang-Yang model construction and reducing to considering the action of the generators in the simple models. We construct some universal models in the formal direct sum of these all simple models, and in this universal model we can enough easy to calculate the action of the generators, and after reducing we obtain the proof of this area. And I have any time explain in detail this proof, and I pass to the second item of our plan, categories of models. And very briefly, the above mentioned theorem the fact about equivalence of the categories of representation. I know that completion in, for example, Yang-Yang and completion has enough various representation theory. And in the case of completion, this difference we have this difference between completions in YAML and bundled superalgebras are isomorphic. And more interesting question about relation between representation of YAML and quantum loop superalgebra. And if you restrict yourself on the some analog of category four of such representation, it's we can obtain the exact theorem about equivalence of such categories. The exact definition is the following. We introduce the category or P representations of Young-Young of superalgebra or special linear superalgebra, which contains such a presentation V such that we done the representation in the terms of the main idea is the following. We consider some category which contains the simple models of Young-Young's and which is closed under the operation of the factor of in this category. And there's some analog of category O. And we restrict some restriction on the analog of the highest weight in the simple model. In the case of Young-Young and quantum loop superalgebra, highest weight is some polynomial. And we consider some restriction of the roots on this polynomial. And as a result, we obtain the sum analog of category O. And the
I'm sorry, Володя, the time is over. Please come to conclusion.
Yes. Minutes. I have any time to continue, and maybe a pair words about classification. The classification of Hopf superalgebra structure can be get classifying the superalgebra Hopf superalgebra structure on quantum loop superalgebra using action of quantum Weyl Weyl groupoid. And using this isomorphism, this classification can be transfers on the Young-Young. And I have any time to continue, and maybe I finished in this point. Thank you for attention and my congratulation to Andrei Konstantinovich at the final. That's all.
Thank you. So okay. we have a little time for a short question and maybe a short answer, please. Okay, if there are no questions, so let's stop here.